So, as Olaf mentioned, it's not a big problem that this session is a little bit short. Quick reminder, first of all, please fill out the World Café. That's the session after this, so you don't have much time anymore. And there are a number of sessions which are missing people, so if you put up a topic there and didn't put your name alongside that, please do that. And another quick mention is this one, that's the QR code for the board election, and there's also the board session before lunch, so if you haven't voted for the board or against the board, you can still do that. And with that being said, let's go to release management. And this was actually a requested session. So you might have heard that we are looking for the OpenCast 14 release manager right now. And people were wondering, so what do you have to do as a release manager? And since I've been a release manager for a few times, and I'm the current release manager for OpenCast 12, or one of the two release managers, which is kind of important also, I thought I'd just talk a little bit about it. I don't really have slides. I brought the Wikipedia page for OpenCast, and I brought a little bit more of a technical instructional things of how the things work internally. And this is essentially what I'm going to talk about a little bit. But yeah, I guess let's start here. What you see here are the different versions of OpenCast, and you see that for a long time there's this one string, and there's now this ladder of releases where you essentially have 1 year of a release cycle for any given major version. And we have scheduled releases, so you can pretty much tell when things will be released, and that also means that when your job as a release manager stops. So what's the big idea here behind a release manager? It's not that this person has to do all the work related to a release, it's more that that person or those persons will take care of the organization of this release. So make sure to remind people that there will be a deadline for new features, for example. Make sure to remind the community, for example, to translate stuff and things like that. And given that the release cycle is about a year, then that also means that this is the time in which you do have some additional work if you volunteer to do that. And going through the default release cycle, OpenCast, let's pick OpenCast 14. We know that OpenCast releases around June 15th and around December 15th. So no one wants to do a release on Sunday, so it can move a little bit, but it's always around that date. So we already know that if you now would volunteer for an OpenCast 14 release manager, then your job is it to remind people that, yeah, there will be a release on June 15th or around that date. Actually, your first job is to make sure that there is a fixed date, so to decide if it's the 15th or the 14th or the 16th. Next is to remind people that there is a date. And all of this is non-technical work, so you don't have to do that. And often there's a pair of release managers, with one being a little bit more technical and one being not technical at all. And so, yeah, you're going around, you're talking to people about that, making sure that they know that there will be the release soon, making sure that people do reviews and pull requests and all this stuff, but you don't actually have to do that yourself. Then obviously there is the date of the release where you do have to do something. Essentially you need to make sure that the release notes are in the documentation. Release notes means the general description of what's new in that release. There's a change log which is automatically generated, so you don't have to do much on that. And then there is the migration documentation, which is kind of, I would say, the most important part of this. I don't know if everyone agrees, but yeah, that's kind of important for all of the adopters follow that. Yeah, and then you have to actually cut the release, which is just the guide for this. This is actually more or less, please execute these six commands in order, and that's it. So this is not actually a lot of work at all, especially since a large part of this is now automated. Then there is the final thing of announcing the release, which nowadays happen on opencast.org. So you just write a short blog post, and that's then automatically, again, lots of automation in, coming in here, being sent to the mailing lists. So you don't have to manually send that anymore. And this is the main responsibility of the release manager. So if you're interested in that, we are really, really happy to get all kinds of people involved from the community, because this is something where you can actually learn lots about Opencast. You also get a very good integration in the community, because people are going to approach you about that. You get lots of connections from this as well, so it's also beneficial for you. But of course, there's not only the main release, so the .0 release, there are more releases than that. And what we have as a rule or as a guideline is there should be, for the first 6 months, more or less monthly release, usually also around the 15th, but it doesn't really matter that much. You can decide where you have to do the same things as with the big releases, just, well, less of everything. So there aren't these huge release notes. It's usually a sentence or two. You have to still do the technical cutting of the release, which is still executing the same six commands. But yeah, that's essentially it. And then for the second half of the year, it's optional releases. We don't do any guarantees from Opencast there. Very, very often, it's still a monthly release, because that's just easier. You don't have to think about it. Obviously, if there isn't, and that often happens, do it at the end of this session, then, well, there's no need to do a release. Often, release managers don't do that on their own. They do that as a team of two release managers, which makes things easier, because if I'm going on vacation, there's someone else which can take care of that. Also, if there is a local issue or something like that where I don't really have time to write documentation right now, someone else can take over, and you just need to make sure that you communicate that with your partner, essentially, in that. Yeah, that's mostly it. Actually, I didn't really need the second part here, which is how the branches and releases work. This is essentially the representation of the Git repository into code, where you have one release branch, and then you have the second release branch cut off at some point, and you start to bring in the code from one to release to the next. But yeah, that's the technical part. That's also fairly well documented. Again, you essentially, if I do the release, I don't think about this anymore. I just copy the commands, and that's it. We are looking for release managers for Opencast 14 right now. The release would be around June 15th. If you're interested in that, and I would really love to see a few new faces in that, please talk to either me or Greg, I would say. If you aren't sure about that, have more questions, or you want an experienced partner or something like that, also just talk to Greg or me. We've done this a couple of times, and there are other people from the community who have done this a couple of times who can always help out and say, okay, you're new, you're kind of inexperienced in that. We can provide a second person to help you out if something goes wrong, and to reassure you that you're doing this alone. And yeah, again, it's a really good position to be in if you want to get connected or get new connections in the community. You are kind of, I forgot about that, forced to present the new release at events like this. But yeah, I guess that's it. I can't really tell you much more about being a release manager. Maybe one last thing. If for any reason there is you have to get out, we will let you leave.
Thanks, Lars. I'm sorry for wasting your time there.
Not a problem.
Any questions? Really?
We have found them. What? We have found them. The next release.
Next release? Did you?
That's great.
That's great. Will you tell us who it is? Thank you very much. Okay, if there are no questions, it's over to coffee. Thanks for your patience.
Actually, it's over to World Cafe.
Oh, it's World.
So, yeah.
Why is it called World Cafe?
Because it's about coffee, I know. Yeah, sorry. I just wanted to remind you. So, you have the, somewhere, there is a list. You have the list of people and topics. Please just go over to the coffee, take a coffee, and then find the people who are, or find the topic you're interested in, and find the people responsible for that topic, and just talk to them. And yeah, you can always switch groups, but this is a little bit to encourage you to talk more about these topics. Last time we did this was a great success, so we hope that you like this time again. So, yeah. And then we come back, I think, for the board meeting.